Hello, and thank you for stopping by our way today. I appreciate you taking a moment of your time to watch these messages. I would like to give you a little thought from God's Word, if I may, concerning the matter of our influence. Influence. The Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 27 and verse number 20, "But the chief priests and elders persuaded the multitude that they should ask Barabbas and destroy Jesus." Now, this is an account leading up to the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. And you remember from this story that the Lord Jesus, after having been arrested, Pilate sees the Lord, and he tells the people, "I'll release a criminal to you. Which one do you want, Barabbas or Jesus?" Well, here the Bible says that the chief priests and elders, they persuaded the people. They didn't come out with guns a-blazing. They didn't come out with swords in their hands and say to the people, "Either you ask of Barabbas or you will die." They didn't force them to. What they did do was they used their influence. They persuaded the people. Now that begs an interesting question, doesn't it? How do you and I use our influence? How do we influence others? Every one of us has a measure of influence. The chief priests and elders had it. The people had influence because later in the story, Pilate said, "I'll release Jesus." And the people cried out. They said, "No, let him be crucified." And then, of course, Pilate, as we know so well, he washed his hands of it and he crucified Jesus. Every person has influence. How do you use it? Now, you can use your influence for good and for God, or you can use your influence for evil. There's no doubt these chief priests, they used theirs for evil, didn't they? They told the people to have an innocent man crucified because they simply hated Jesus. They were envious of him. They said, you tell Pilate to crucify Jesus. That was an evil use of their influence. Now, we find other examples in the Bible where people use their influence for good. You know, I think of Moses and how he influenced Joshua, a young man. I think of how Paul mentored Timothy. He influenced him for the right things. The Lord Jesus had his disciples. He influenced his disciples. I mean, the list could go on. But the point is, you can use your influence for good or you could use it for evil. So the question I have for you today is, how are you using your influence? There is power in influence. Now, we don't believe that believers ought to use the power of the state to try to force a person to believe anything or try to force a man to do anything. But we do believe that every one of us has influence. How are we going to use it? I know when you speak to people about faith in Christ or maybe about attending a church, I know sometimes you can come across the excuse, "Well, I'm not going to church because there's too many hypocrites." Well, I don't mind going on record as saying that that's just an excuse. I know that. But I will also say this. I know there have been a lot of people hurt by professing Christians. There have been a lot of people hurt because of hypocrites. I know that. And you know something? I don't want to be the man who gives another excuse to someone else. I don't want to be the fella who turns someone else away. And you know, to be quite honest, I don't want to be the man who makes someone twofold more a child of hell. Because in my selfishness and in my pride, I chose to live for me rather than for the Lord. I still believe the Christian life is a holy life. And if you're going to use your influence for good, you must not only talk the talk, you must walk the walk. Let's be a people who use our influence for good. Let's be a people who, when we encourage others to attend a church and we encourage others to get in the Bible and pray, they know that we are serious about it in our lives. And what we're saying is not just empty words, but it's truth that's bubbling up from our souls, and it's made a difference in us. The Bible speaks in Romans chapter 14 of not putting a stumbling block before someone else. Are you casting a stumbling block by your life? There are things, honestly, I could do. I mean, things I could do in my life. But there are also things that I ought not to do simply because it could hurt someone else. I don't want to use my influence for evil. You know, we could talk about a number of issues here. But I just want to give a couple of thoughts of it. You know, I believe Christians ought to use clean language, because what does it say of our Lord when we go to the job site or we get around others and we say, well, I'm a Christian, and then we talk filthy, we tell the dirty jokes, we laugh at filthy things, crude language. What does that say? It is not using our influence rightly. How about being a hard worker on the job? If you're a lazy person, it would be better for you never to say you're a Christian, because your bosses know what you profess. And if you're a lazy individual, they don't want to hear anything you've got to say about the Lord, because they already know how you live your life. Let's use our influence for good. You know, as we live our lives day by day, I don't want to be the man who is one person at church and someone else anytime I'm not at church. I don't want to wear one face at church and then have another face when I'm at home, in front of my wife, in front of my children, or in front of my friends or family members. Let's use our influence rightly. Every one of us has influence, some greater than others, but we all have it. Let's use our influence for good and for God. I hope you have a great day today. May the Lord bless you, and let's use our influence for His name's sake. God bless you.